you want to start using a VPN but not sure if this thing is something you would cope with, look no further. Today we will cover 4 easy steps on how to use a VPN and cover some of the FAQs so that even if you're a complete newbie in using a VPN, you won't be scared of them anymore, I promise. The mechanics of using a VPN are simple, and no matter which VPN app you use, the process is typically the same, and the first step you want to do is to sign up for a VPN plan. Now, first of all, keep in mind that even though the real purpose of a VPN provider is to hide your IP address or to change your IP address and to encrypt your internet traffic, each and every VPN provider is different. For example, one thing to consider is the speed. And if you have a slow internet connection, some VPN providers might not be usable for you at all. In this case, try to pick up the VPN provider that uses WireGuard tunneling protocol. It will make the decrease in your internet speed less noticeable. Next, you should think about why you are getting a VPN in the first place. Would it be to watch Netflix from another country, or would you like to just stay safe online while using public Wi-Fi's? So what is your initial purpose? By the way, let me know in the comments, what is your purpose of using a VPN? Always read the feature list of the VPN you are interested in. And finally, look for a VPN that is compatible with your device. Like, nowadays, most VPN providers do provide several versions of their apps for different operational systems. However, you should better check. Once you found your perfect match, the next step would be to download and install the app that you have chosen. Download the VPN from the official website of your VPN provider. It should have multiple options for different operational systems, for Windows, for Mac, for iOS, for Android, and downloading them should be actually a breeze. A side note here, just so that you're not getting frustrated with the terms, is that a VPN software for desktops is called a VPN client, whilst a VPN software for mobile apps is called VPN app, but typically these are the same VPN software. Also, additionally, some VPN services provide a number of extensions that you can set up in your browser, such as Google Chrome, Firefox, Opera, and some others. The next step would be simple, and that is run your client app. Now it's really time to use your VPN, and the last step you will have to do is to log in using your email address and your password. These are the login details that you used when purchasing a subscription. To connect to another country, simply open the application, browse through the list of the countries available, and click on the one that you need. Once you don't need to be connected to a VPN anymore, click the disconnect button and your connection will be back to normal. In case you want to tweak a feature or two, e.g. select a different tunneling protocol, change the encryption method, or use split tunneling, you'll need to open the settings menu. There, you will be able to see all the extra features offered by your VPN. Now, many VPN apps have a big friendly connect button that will connect you to the nearest VPN server that will almost undoubtedly connect you to the fastest VPN server that is less loaded and the fastest of the ones available. Now, what happens next? After you install and run your VPN app, it connects to a VPN server run by your VPN provider. All data into and out of your device is now securely encrypted and routed through this VPN tunnel. The VPN server therefore acts as a gateway between you and the internet. It prevents your ICP, internet service provider, from seeing what you're doing on the web, and prevents websites from seeing who you are and from further targeting you with their ads. Now you know how to use a VPN even if you're a complete newbie in using VPN services. If you do, smash the like button, I'd appreciate that, and make sure to stay tuned for our next episodes, because we will talk about how to choose a good VPN provider. If you're interested, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to not miss that, and I will see you really soon on this channel. See you soon. Bye.